Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started tutorial about the Blazor Sparkline charts of Synfusion. In general, the Sparkline charts are a small kind of charts that are drawn without any axis. You can convey more information to the users by allowing them to visualize the detailed data in a very small amount of compact space. You can also integrate them within other controls like grid. To explore about the Synfusion Blazor Sparkline chart, refer the website link shown in the above YouTube card. Over the next few minutes, I will show you how to add Synfusion Blazor Sparkline chart to Blazor Server app and explain you how to change the Sparkline chart type and enable few of its basic features like data label, markers, and tooltip. Also, I will show you how to integrate the Sparkline charts in grid component at last. Before I start to create a Blazor application, first I need to make sure whether .NET Core SDK latest version is installed in my machine and I should have Visual Studio Code or Visual Studio 2019. In this tutorial, I'm going to create a new server-side Blazor app. So, let me open the Visual Studio 2019 first and create a new project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, I will choose Blazor app and click next to proceed further with the project creation. Here, I will name my project as Blazor example and click the create button. Next, I will choose this Blazor server app option and click this create button finally to complete the project creation. Now, the project has been created and ready to use. If you want to know more about the Blazor server app and how to add Synfusion components to it, then you can listen to the video link that is shown in the above YouTube card. Now, I will tell you the steps to add Blazor Sparkline chart. To start using the Synfusion Blazor Sparkline chart, first I need to install the Synfusion Blazor NuGet package into my application. For that, I will open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project and choose the option Manage NuGet Packages. Then, I will search for Synfusion Blazor in the Browse tab and install it into my project. Once the installation gets completed, let me navigate to imports.razor file and here, I will add Synfusion Blazor charts namespace to start using the Blazor Sparkline chart in any of the components available under the Pages folder. Next, I will open the startup.cs file and here, I will add the Synfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I will register the Synfusion Blazor service by calling a method addSynfusionBlazor within the configure services method. Also, I should register the valid license key into my application. So, let me register the trial license key using the register license method. The next important thing is, I need to define the CSS for Sparkline chart. Therefore, let me navigate to host.cshtml file under the Pages folder to refer the CSS file from the installed Synfusion Blazor package. Now, everything is configured, so let me start to add the Blazor Sparkline chart. For that, I need to open the index.razor component and here I will include the tag SF Sparkline. Next, I will start to populate the data for the Sparkline chart. For that, first I need to create a code block. Here, I have planned to display yearly temperature data in the Sparkline chart. So, let me define a model class weather data with two fields namely month and value. Then, I need to create a list, temperature data of the type weather data and assign appropriate values to the data source fields. To the Sparkline chart, I need to specify the data source type. So, let me define a property T value and set its value as weather data. Then, I will assign this object temperature data to the data source property and map the data source fields month to xname and value to yname property of the Sparkline chart. Here, I have used the categorized data for the x-axis. So, first I need to define the property value type and set its value as category. Along with this, I will also define the properties height and width with custom values to display sparkline chart with custom size. Now, I will run this example. So here, you can see the sparkline chart rendered with custom height and width. By default, you can see the sparkline chart type is line. Suppose, if I want to display sparkline chart series type as area, then I need to define the property type and set its sparkline type as area. See the output page now. The area sparkline chart is rendered. Now, I will show you how to enable data markers to highlight the data points. To add data markers, first I need to define sparkline marker settings tag inside the Blazor sparkline chart code. Then, I will define the property visible, which is of type array. For this visible property, I can pass different visibility types to customize the data marker's visibility of sparkline chart. The available visibility types are start, end, all, high, low, and negative. Now, I'm going to display data markers for all the data points. So, let me assign the visibility type as all to this visible property. Along with this, I have also set the sparkline chart type as line here. And now, you can see the sparkline chart displaying data marker on each of its data points. Next, let me proceed to show you how to add data label for sparkline chart to display information about the data point. To add data labels, first I need to define sparkline data label settings tag inside the Blazor sparkline chart code. Then, I will define the property visible, which is of type array. For this visible property, I can pass different visibility types to customize the data label visibility of sparkline chart. The available visibility types are start, end, all, high, low, and negative. Now, I'm going to display data label for both the start and end data points. So, let me assign the visibility types as start and end to this visible property. Also, I have planned to add padding values for both the ends of the sparkline chart. So, first I need to define the sparkline padding tag inside the Blazor sparkline chart code. Then, I will define the properties left and right with custom values. So here, you can see the Blazor sparkline chart displaying data labels on both the start and end points. Next, I'm going to show you how to make the sparkline charts more interactive by adding tooltips to it. To add the tooltip to the sparkline chart, I will define sparkline tooltip settings tag and set its visible property as true. Look at the output page now. The tooltip is shown for every data point of the sparkline chart. Finally, I will proceed to show you how to integrate sparkline chart in grid component. To make it clear, let me remove the Blazor sparkline chart code from here. As I said before, I'm going to integrate sparkline chart in grid component. So, to work with grid component, first I need to open the imports.razor file and import the namespace Synfusion Blazor Grids. Then, to add grid component, I will include the tag sfgrid. Here, I have planned to display grid component with orders data. So, within this code block, I will define a model class orders data with four fields, namely ID, name, date, and ship country. Then, I will create a list orders of type orders data and assign appropriate values to the data source fields. Next, I need to bind data source and data source type to grid component. So, Let me define the properties data source and t value with appropriate values. Now, I'm going to display all the four data source fields in grid. So, within this grid columns tag, I will add four grid column tags with appropriate properties like field, header text, text align, format, and width. Next, I'm going to add sparkline chart to the grid component as a separate column using template property. For that, first I need to add one more grid column with the properties header text, text align, and width. Then, I will define the template tag inside the grid column tag. Now, I will include sparkline chart with the properties value type, line width, type, fill, height, and width. Next, let me start to generate some random data for chart. So, I will create a list chart data of the type integer and assign some numeric values to it. Then, I will assign this variable chart data to the data source property of the sparkline chart. Here, to display sparkline chart with its corresponding data in each grid row, I need to iterate through the appropriate chart data. So, let me define a variable chart data index of type integer with the value 0 and increment the chart data index value. And then I will assign this variable chart data index to the data source property of the sparkline chart. Now everything is done. So here you can see the output page. The sparkline chart is rendered within the grid component like this. Now, let me make a quick recap of what we have seen so far. We have seen how to create a Blazor project using Visual Studio 2019 and added a Synfusion Blazor Sparkline chart component in a server-side application. Also, we have seen how to render Sparkline chart with basic features like data label, data markers, and tooltip. Finally, we have also seen how to integrate Sparkline chart in grid component. If you would like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link which I have shared in the description part below. You can also grab your chance of getting free license key to use our complete Blazor products if you fit into our community license guidelines. So, check the link given in the description part to know if you are eligible for using our community license. Also, if you find this video as useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching this video.